You are not going to fail. You are not going to fall. Don't bother about what the picture the devil is painting to you. It will be better than this in Jesus' name. You are going forward. Just begin to thank him and bless his holy name. Exalt him, magnify him. Give him more. It's more than enough. All sufficient God. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Can we just encourage ourselves a little bit, even as we rejoice before the Lord and we sing from the bottom of our heart? There's no one like Jehovah. There's no one like Jehovah. There's no one like Jehovah.
Let your voice, 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 let your Oh,
Of that person and look at the person with a smile. Say, my sister, don't worry, he's with you. It will end well. You will make it. You will not lose yourself. You will not go mad. You will not lose your mind. God will help you. I don't know how it's going to happen, but he will do it. This song I've been living with for the past 2 months now. You don't have to worry. Don't leave that person.
You be afraid. Trouble comes in the morning.
Trouble, they don't last
long.
You have a friend in Jesus.
I have a friend in Jesus. Who will wipe my tears away.
Tell that person, if your heart is hurting, just lift up your hand. Destiny, help me. Help me. Help me. Help me. Can you just call upon him? You are the only one I have. Thank you, Father. Only you are holy. Only you. Holy, for there is no one
like you, who is faithful
ever to my education. Help me my career. Help me my marital life. Cry to him. Cry to him. Some people are not praying. Cry to him. I need your help. You are the only one that can help me. I need your help, Lord. Help me. Help me. Help me.
And I believe. Yes, Lord.
Take away my fears. Every fear I have about my future. Every fear about my life. Every fear I have about my career. Every fear I have about my destiny. Father, take it away. Father, take it away. Father, take it away.
But for your grace, now will it guide my way. And I'm forever grateful that you have been faithful to me, Lord, for your amazing grace.
But for your grace,
but for your grace.
Something here this morning.
Lord, you are welcome.
God is about to do something in the life of somebody
here. Lord, you are welcome in this place. Lord, you are welcome in this place.
Spirit, you, we are nothing.
Talk to the Lord. Oh, yeah.
Amen. Have your seat. God bless you. As you close your eyes, you are going to pray one prayer point. Hello? Hello? I want you to pray one prayer point now. Forget the person by your side. Don't look at the person. If the person is wearing the best designer dress, it's not your business. Just pray this prayer. Forget about what we are wearing. Forget about who is by your side. And get yourself ready. If you have ever watched American Idol, when somebody goes for audition, and they give the person a ticket. You know the way they shout. That's the way I want you to shout now. Get yourself ready. I want you to cry louder than the person by your side. I call this prayer somewhere, and there's been a lot of testimony and a lot of prayer. From where I'm coming from this
this morning to pray the prayer, I want you to pray it. Close your eyes and raise up your hand. Say, Father, open a door for me that is bigger than me. In the name of Jesus. God bless you, that sister. That's how to pray it. The door that is bigger than me. In Jesus' name, pray. Are you ready? Raise up your hands again. Something is going to happen to 17 people now. As I'm praying now. As we pray now, something is going to happen. God is about to turn some things around. Are you ready? Shout this after me loud and clear. Say, Father! Convert my disappointment to promotion. In the name of Jesus. Papa la kaya boso tonda kapa. In Jesus' name, pray. Wave your hands like this. It's prophetic. And get yourself ready. Don't allow somebody's voice to cover your own. God bless you, that brother. Get ready to shout. MFM is a place of shouting. Amen. It's a shouting prayer. Are you ready? Say this after me. Say, in the name of Jesus, every evil pronouncement and prophecy over my life, I reverse them in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and begin to reverse. God bless you, that sister. Reverse it in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, pray. Close your eyes. Close your eyes. We are still praying. We are still praying. Jesus, the rende ke rende bosu parazata paradisa katayaba. Get yourself ready to pray. Don't allow somebody's voice to be louder than your own. Say, powers. You are waking up gradually. Get yourself ready again. Say, powers that wants to convert me to a dummy. Do you know the meaning of a dummy? And Joe Moshe, who don't know how to do anything. He has certificates, he has everything, but he knows he can perform, but the world has made him somebody that cannot do anything. Get yourself ready. Say, powers that wants to turn me to a dummy. Your time is up. Open your mouth and pray. In Jesus' name, pray. Place your two hands on your head. Let them be silent. Don't pray, don't speak a tongue. Just hold still. Hold still. You have been struggling with this spirit. The spirit of failure and the age of miracle. It looks as if it's going to work, but it will not work. Father, let them be silent, please. Where are those people you showed me now? Let your power come upon them. Set them free right there now. look at this sister. You are not even supposed to be here now. There's a place you're supposed to be now. But look at what they have done for you. Uh-huh. The power of God is coming upon you. Yes. You, the spirit of the father of that brother that is following him about, let him go. Uh-huh. That's right. That's right. There's a sister here from River State. You are from River State. You are from River State. What they did to your mother is what they want to do to you. But because you are here this morning, right there where you are, the power of God is coming upon you. And they are reversing some things over your life now. Let them be silent. Let's wait for that to happen. That's right. That's right. That's right. That's right. Let her go. That is very good. That is very good. That is very good. Lord, the mark on I am seeing on the head of this person that is making the person to be hated anywhere he goes. Yes, by the blood of Jesus. Let that mark be removed. 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 That's right. That's right. That's right. That's right. Yes. Yes. Let them be silent. What has this person done to you? Why have you turned her glory into shame? Why are you making life difficult for this person? You, this strong man, right there, the fire of God is burning all over you, that person. Now, let them go. Let her go. Let him 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 go. That's right. You are using the spirit of delay to fight her. Okay, release her now. You demon of delay. Oh yeah, let her go. At the count of 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Get out. I say you can't delay her. I count 7 again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. In the name of Jesus, let her go. Who are these 3 people I'm seeing? 3 is number. How can you be following your mates from behind? Your mate are in the front. What are you doing at the back? Why are you following your mate from the back? Holy Ghost, where are those 3 people? Set them free. Set them free. 3 in number. Set them free. That's number 1. That's number 2. That's number 3. I command you, come out from the back of your mate. In the name of Jesus. Uh-huh. That's the power of God coming upon you. Uh-huh. That is doing something again, though. The arrow of evil odor you are smelling to people. You just notice a kind of strange smell in your body. Yes, you are the one, that person. Right there where you are, the power. Mariana Kapalima, Rubia Kasatayaba. Yes, that odor is coming out. It's an arrow. It's coming out. It's coming out. It's coming out. It's coming out. Go in the name of Jesus. That's right. Your mouth will no longer smell to your hairpats. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. For you are glorious and worthy to be praised. You are the Lamb upon the throne. Oh, and unto you I will lift a voice in prayer. You are the Lamb upon I decree into the life of somebody here, if your amen can be heard in the house you are staying, beginning from today, failure will not be your size again. In the name of Jesus, I decree upon your life, Maruzi Gabada, Gabulizandakaba, Barika Zandika Buyaba. Yende kulima sundiria runda kuniata. I decree upon your life, if your amen can cover 50 people by your side, beginning from today, this Sunday in February, I decree upon your head and upon your destiny, anywhere you go, you will find favor in Jesus' name. You will find favor. You will find favor. You will find favor in the name of Jesus. Hey, thank you, Father. Nehemiah chapter 9. Say to somebody by your side, say, God will help me. That's what we are looking at. We conclude our prayer section. Amen. Say it again. Say it again. Say it again. Okay, that person was not like me. Look for another person again. Nehemiah chapter 2, I read from verse 9. Then I came to the governors beyond the river, this Nehemiah, rebuilding the walls of Jerusalem. The wall of Jerusalem has been destroyed. Jerusalem has been made a waste. It has become ruins. It has become a dunghill where bats, all filthy animals, everything. It doesn't matter where you are coming from. Your foundation notwithstanding. It doesn't matter who your father was or who your mother was. In fact, when they came to anoint David, amen, they said he was not at home. They said, where is he? He said, he's in the wilderness. So David was a remnant child. He was not needed. They said he was the youngest child, but they sent him to the wilderness to go and be looking after animals. That was where David wrote most of his psalms. He wrote. He wrote Psalm 91. He wrote Psalm 35. Psalm 68. Psalm 27. That's where he prayed, my head will be lifted up. Amen. Look at somebody by your side. Say, it's only temporary. This is not the finished work. You are just, I'm in a process. Say, God is about to package me now. By the time he finished with me, I will become a trailblazer. I will become a bestseller. Say, my friend, better sit down very well. If you want to touch me, touch me. But the time is coming You will need to wait in the reception before you see me. The person that are talking to, they know themselves. I want to my Lord, they want to marry. We know ourselves. You will make it in Jesus' name. I say you will make it. No devil will stop you. No power will stop you. You don't serve a dead God. You serve a living God. He is the same today. He is the same yesterday. He is the same forever. For the Lord God will help you. If you believe it, shout yeah. Amen. Verse 9. And they came to the governors beyond the river and gave the king letter. And the king said unto the captains of the army and the horsemen with him, verse 10. This is where we are going now. When Sanballat the foreigner, and he will see his name, Sanballat the foreigner, foreigner. Amen. And Tobiah the servant, and the Ammonite, head of it. It grieved them exceedingly. Are you there? It grieved them exceedingly. That what? That there was born a man to see the welfare of the children of Israel. Who want to help her to get admission? Who want to help him get a job? Where? In Shem, Jephron. Who want to help him? Who want to marry him? Who want to marry her? What have you been hearing about you from February? It's not what they have been hearing, but they shall begin to hear positive things about you. I'm saying now, some people here, I'm sorry to say, you will need to break Goya of oil on their head, because they are more negative. Nigeria, I was telling people this morning, Nigerians are negative. Tony Blair said something, and I listened during the dedication of the Rock in Lekki. He was in Pastor Paul Adefara's church. He was saying that Nigeria, he has never seen a country like this country. He said all talents, resources you are looking for in the world is present in Nigeria. He said everything Nigeria needs to succeed is in Nigeria, but the only problem he has is that he doesn't know what is wrong. Everything we need to here, the resources that are supposed to be for 100 people is in the hand of one person. What belongs to you? What will benefit you that some people are sitting on? That seat will become hot seat. I said that seat will become hot seat. Listen to me. Look, I came to shock you and embarrass you. Because if you think that it is over for you, you are a joker. If you think that this is how this will continue, you are a liar. Because things are going to get better than what you think. The Bible says, he said, I will give you wells you did not dig. I will give you vineyards you did not plant. He said, remember not the former things, neither consider the things of old. He said, behold, I will do a new thing. Shall ye not know it? I will make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. I have a word for somebody here. God is about to unlock doors for you. God is about to open heavens for you. God is about to open doors for you. In the name of Jesus, if you believe it, shall ye. Don't mind me. Mind me, my story is like that of Akururu. He said, when I was normal, the world did not accept me. Now I've become abnormal, they are accepting me. So somebody, he told some people, he said, I will never be well in Jesus' day. Because it's this my state of madness that I am making money. I'm counting money. I decree upon your life, no matter whether you have pharmacy certificate, whether you have ONG, whatever you have does not matter. I know a God that is able to do exceedingly abundantly, far above all that we have asked or that we have thought about. I speak to you by the voice of deliverance. If your amen can be louder than the person by your side, from this February, you will arise and shine. You will arise and shine. You will arise and shine. In the name of Jesus, I speak to you by the Spirit of God. In your career, favor. Maritally, favor. In your home, favor. In your job, favor. Everywhere you go, favor. If you believe it, shout yeah. They were not expecting God to help them. He said, Jerusalem will remain like this. You will be forever like this. Do you know, even while you are here, there is somebody somewhere God is speaking to you now about you. Amen. There are people carrying fire on your behalf. And say, please, what can you do to help this, my sister? Your next application to any embassy will result in breakthrough. I say your next application to any embassy will result in breakthrough. In the name of Jesus, I speak to you by the Spirit of God. Thank God for Pastor David. He's in America now. The God that made him to be over there. You know that place they say you will not get to. I prophesy upon your life. Within the next 3 months, those that say you will not get there, you will call them from that place. I say you will call them from there. I say you will call them from there. In the name of Jesus. David said, for the Lord God will help me. Wherefore I will not be confounded. I have set my face like a flint, and I know that I will not be ashamed. Stop looking down. Look at somebody. Say, Lord, stop looking down. Say, look up. Tell somebody again. Say, shake your body. Shake your body. Shake away depression. Shake away worry. God is able to bring out visible from invisible. One day I was thinking, and the Lord told me, he said, son, have you finished? I said, yes. He said, you know that your brain compared to my own brain is like picking one grain of sand and the rubbish. Daddy, what do you mean? He said, I know what you want, but I have something better. Why worry when you can pray? Satan loves it when you sit down and think and magnify your problem. You are not supposed to magnify your problem, you are supposed to magnify God. The more you magnify your problem and you worry and you sit down, you don't want to eat, you don't want to take care of yourself. My people, anytime I have issues in life, that's the time I go and enjoy myself. I'll just look for one. You know, there are godly films you can watch in the cinema. I just go and sit down. I won't want anybody to see me. I will put on glasses. Can go and report me to Jim, it doesn't matter. I'll watch, buy 3 popcorn. That's where I met people that always beg for popcorn. I was standing, I wanted to collect my popcorn. I saw a beautiful lady, I thought maybe she was lining up at my back. Suddenly she just said, excuse me, sir, can you buy me 2 popcorn? I said, ah. So they are begging, they are doing popcorn beggars in this place.
and I don't want the person to hospital. I just gave him to my city. It's okay. Amen. You must learn to be happy. Anytime you are sad, negative energies and energies are multiplying themselves. Anytime you are happy, God is gaining more control. You know, there are times that you may not feel like laughing, but you just have to laugh. I received some quotes on my phone. I don't know whether it's true or not. They sent me from MTN. They discovered that when you are frowning, you are reducing in lifespan per second. But when you are laughing, it increases and boosts humility and longevity. Amen. It also means, they said again, that, who is laughing like that? That person needs deliverance. I've never heard that kind of laugh before. Amen. Don't laugh like that again. Laugh very, very well. Amen. You know, there's a laugh between somebody that drink gari or Elto Muti Alagbada. You know what they call tea Alagbada? Tea without what? Sugar. Drop one, look for one big bowl and drop one limtin inside. Then buy one long Ghana Ogagege bread. That's what you call tea Alagbada. Praise the name of the Lord. We have different kind of laughter. The laugh of the established person. Amen. So don't laugh like that. I want you to laugh like a great man now. For 1 second, I give you time. Some people are not laughing, no. It shows that you don't laugh. Because some people are looking for laughter inside of them. They are searching for laughter. I say, I give you 1 minute to laugh. The Bible says, weeping endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. No problem. You see, sometimes people even pray out of fear. They pray out of fear. I don't carry prayer. You carry all the books, put them in the front. I pray. Gather all the Palm of Strangers prayer from 1997. Begin to pray. There are times you just have to wait in His presence. You just have to sit down there. Just serenade His presence. Just magnify Him. Just worship Him. Forget about it. Forget about what you are going through, what you are passing through. There's nothing happening to you that has not happened to somebody before. Ah, really, I've been there before. It has happened before. There's nothing new. The preacher said there's nothing new under the heaven. Say, but time and chance happen to them. You are not here by your own plan. You are here this morning because God wanted you to be here at this particular time to come and hear this word that is coming out to you now, that God will help you. I say, God will help you. Raise up your two hands and say, oh Lord, help me. Amen. Who remember them? Do you know their powers? Who don't want good things to happen to you? Paul said the door of opportunity is open unto me. But they are what? They are many adversaries. The door of opportunity. Go and read about great men, what they passed through to become who they are today. Go and look at how they suffered. Go and look at what they passed through. But look at where they are today. Because don't ever forget that God is not a loser. God has never lost a battle. If you are here and God appeared to you, or you saw in the Bible somewhere that God failed and God lost a battle, come and show me. Or God told you that, I'm sorry, I cannot solve this situation. Satan is more powerful. Have you experienced that thing before? Say never. Say it can never happen. Our God. shows up. The Bible says, he that sit on the sacrifice of the earth, and the inhabitants are like grasshoppers. He said, I kill and I make alive. He said, I walk. Who can hinder my walk? Who have come to help these people? Who wants to assist them? Listen to me. Never depend on human being. Depend on God. God will use human being for you. There are some of you, God uses some people for you, and then you now sit down there. You prepare a back. Say, ah, this is my helper. Who told you that's your helper? That's just one of them. There are many more. You only know one way. God knows 1 billion. If man shuts one door, God can open all the doors in the earth. God can enter a country and save a prostitute. Only one person. Jesus entered Jericho and came out. He didn't touch any other person. He only helped blind Bartimaeus. That's the only person he touched. The mercy of God is here this morning. What are you going through? Afraid of? What bothers you when nobody is by your side? Thank God for the Spirit of God upon your life. You can be anointed, it doesn't matter. But what are you passing through that you cannot share with others? You know, sometimes we youths, we are so egoistic that you don't want people to know that these things and or such things is happening to you. And you just want to cover it down. Said, I repeat again, he said, for the Lord God will help me. Help come from God. He said, promotion does not come from east, nor from west, but from where? But from God. It is God that does wondrous works. God does not like to come the way he came the last time. If he comes the way he came the last time, he's not God. He likes to do new things. The Bible says, his mercies are new every morning. He's a God of new things. It's not limited. You are limited. God is unlimited. He loves to do new things. What are you worrying about? What is Satan using to scare you? What is he using to gag you? And say, yes, I've got you here. I've got you there. I've got you here. God can convert your mess to a message. He can convert your troubles to a topic. They can turn your season around. They can make the wilderness to be a pool of water. They can turn your dry land into rivers. They can command water to spring out of wells. He fed 5,000 with 5 fishes and 3 loaves of bread. He has done it before. He cannot fail. He is too big to fail. He cannot disappoint himself. He said, concerning my word, command ye me. I prophesy upon your life. By the Spirit of the living God. Today, Sunday, if you can say amen, nobody has said before, God will continue and will begin to unlock doors for you. In the name of Jesus, He will cover your nakedness, He will wipe your tears, He will remove your sorrow. He will remove your garment of mourning. He will give you a garment of praise. He will remove the spirit of heaviness. Your limitations shall be destroyed. Your embargo shall be broken. I speak to you by the Spirit of God. Your head shall be lifted up. God will lift up your head. God will help you. Your help will come from God, who made the heavens and the earth. God to help me, servant of some things I'm doing that are not right. I'm trying to help myself, but I cannot help myself anymore. Raise up your hand wherever you are. I want to pray with you. God bless you, that sister. God bless you, that brother. I can't see your hands. And you want to rededicate your life afresh. Now rise up on your feet. All those raising up your hand. God bless you. I can see you. God bless you, that sister. I see you where you are. God bless you, that brother. I see you where you are. Come forward wherever you are. Come forward quickly because of our time. I just want to pray for you.
Oh, yeah.
One more time. Fame is okay. The two hands of the person. You are going to pray for the person is going to pray for you. Press the hand of the person until the person say yay. Press the hand of the person until the person say kilode. Are you ready? You are going to shout at the person is going to shout at you. Say powers! Time. I don't want God to answer you 2 months times. I want God to answer you. Everybody say now. Say powers. Can you shout it with thunder in your voice? Holding your career down. Can you shout it again? In the name of Jesus. That is it. Yes. In Jesus' name we pray. Turn and grab another person again. Check the hand of the person whether he is using edge or he is using 4G. If he's using edge, that means he's using Starcom. Look for somebody with Swift or Spectranet. Get your, or even Vodafone now. They are around in Nigeria. Grab that person. Shout this at the person loud and clear. Ask for the name of the person. What's your name? Just one of the name. That's all. Say, Samuel! Against your manifestation. Yes. A potenda kapata yaba. Rika potenda paya. Marie Masuta likaya. In Jesus' name, pray. Oh, yeah, grab another person again. Now, as you are praying with that person, the reason why you are holding that person is because you are only agreeing with the person now. Now, what do you want God to do for you? Now, you are going to leave your own. You are going to pray for your brother. Don't tell anybody what. Don't tell them. Just know it in your mind. You are going to shout on the head of that person you are holding. Say, oh, God, hurry! Know the name of the person. What's your name? Please, say, please, what's your name? Oh God, help somewhere in the name of Jesus. One shall chase 1,000, two shall chase 10,000. Oh God! Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Stand on your own now. Stand on your own now. Stand on your own now. Raise up your two hands. Raise up your. I will know whether you love yourself or not. The way you, more than the prayer you pray for that person, you are going to pray for yourself now. Sambalat and Tobiah said, Who wants to help this person? Who wants to assist this person? He never buy car. He won't. He not go buy car. He not go even collect visa. Not to talk of get money for ticket. Say, who have come to help this person? Get yourself ready. I want you to be hungry. When you look at your father and your mother, you go pray. I want you to, with boiling anger, with the spirit of Kolomenta, enough is enough. Shout this loud and clear. Say, power! Say, nobody will help me. Can you shout it again? Brothers, I see a brother has removed his suit. He's good like that. Just remove, leave it alone. If you want to roll your trouser, roll your trouser. This is the battle of your life. You must not pray this prayer again. This is the last time you are going to pray this prayer. Amen. Amen. If you are supposed to be in UK and you are still coming for choir practice in Nigeria, when your destiny is somewhere else, and they say, sister, so, how are you? Say, I'm fine. He said, what do you eat today? I eat indomie. He heard no correct. Are you ready? Say, power! If your destiny is supposed to be in America, maybe by now you're supposed to be working in Cisco in America or working with IBM. As I'm talking, some people are looking at me and say, what's this man saying? Good thing will not be strange to you. Some people are used to hearing, I need money. I don't have credit. Me now, I don't know when I've said I don't have credit before on my phone. I don't even remember. Because not too long ago, both Airtel and MTN, they sent me. They said that, sir, you have moved from diamond. Is it from platinum to diamond or? So you are now a special. You can sit down in any lodge anywhere in the country. I say, why did it happen like that? They say, you are always buying credit. I say, I don't even know how much is there. Praise the name of the Lord. It's somebody that is flashing that know that you have 2 naira left. Amen. You will leave the group of those people in the name of Jesus. Are you ready? Say, nobody will help me. Are you my God?